after a very, very impressive 2-0 start. PSG Talon, including a victory over LGD Gaming that basically nobody saw coming. They start 2-0 in Group B. Extremely impressive stuff here. What stood out for you the most, Tyler?
I was so impressed by their chemistry, which maybe I should be super like surprised by, because some of these players have played on the same team before, and you know, this is like a Taiwanese super team outside of their AD carry D. And D was the biggest surprise for me, right? He hasn't played professionally since 2019. He hasn't played in the tier one Taiwanese or Pacific League since 2017. He's been in the Challenger series before becoming a coach this year for Machi. And he was a last minute sub in to play in the World Championship. Almost any situation you would think of this is that the guy's going to get rolled, right? He's going to get destroyed. But he's played so well, and the entire team, from Uniboy to Kongwe to just everyone on the team, and especially Kai Wing. Kai Wing, just in terms of pure performance, was the MVP of the day. His Bard was one of the cleanest Bards you will ever see in pro play. Every time Rainbow Seven tried to do anything, every time they tried to set up a fight, they were always getting picked out, and their first member they got picked off by Bard was cleaned off the map. They had never were able to get a grip hold in that match. So Kai Wing on the Rakan and the Bard were incredible. It's a story that we're going to think about for years from now. And I think that's one of the things I love most about Worlds, right? Worlds is where nobodies become somebodies, where superstars become legends, and where legends become immortalized forever. And for someone like D, no one in the Western scene, or even in the general League of Legends scene in general, even in Taiwan, probably wouldn't have remembered his name ever. He was just going to be a coach. He had a middling career as a player. He was a coach on Machi. But this moment, him coming off the bench, coming out of not even the bench, he is coming from the coaching booth to play at the World Championship, not even on his own team, on the rival team, PSG Talon, and to perform so admirably, especially on Jhin. It's a story we're going to remember for ages. We're going to remember the story 5-10 years from now about how PSG and this ragtag team with D, a coach, coming in last minute, beat LGD Gaming, the, you know, one of the hometown favorite teams from the dominant two-time back-to-back Chinese championship region. So it's just an incredible story. This is why I love Worlds, Arda, because you get stories like these that you never knew was going to happen. No one was going to pick PSG to take LGD today. There was always a chance, but I didn't think there was any chance. I thought they would lose their game to Rainbow Seven. I didn't believe that a coach could come from nowhere and even be decent. But he was better than decent. He was so, so dang good, man. And just this team in general, from Kongwei's, from his Echo in Game 1 to Uniboy's Orianna in Game 2, this team played so well and so coordinated that I just have to tip my cap to them. I love Team Liquid. They played great, but the team of the day is PSG. They are by far the most impressive team I've seen in the play-in so far.
Oh, yeah. They turned so many heads, and they're the Cinderella team now. Oh, yeah. They have cemented themselves as the Cinderella story of the play-ins, if anything. And just to echo your sentiments about D, like, I love the story, Tyler, of a coach leading, helping his team make it to Worlds, make it to the big dance, and then getting called in to another team to help them get out of a rival team in the same region to help them get to groups, right? It's like, it's just crazy. Incredible. Like, they won't meet each other in the groups, obviously, because they're from the same region. But, like, imagine if that story, I mean, this is extremely unlikely, but imagine if that story ends with PSG make groups, both of them somehow make it out of groups, and then they meet in the knockout stage. That would be, like, an all-time world story. It would ever happen, but.
I mean, who knows? Who knows, Arda? Who knows? Who
stranger
knows how good
things have happened,
who knows?
Right?
Stranger things have happened. Albus Nox Luna made corner finals in 2016. Nothing, after watching what happened yesterday, who knows what's going to happen? Things happen so quickly at Worlds. Metas can shift on a dime. But I'm just so happy that this team that a lot of people were overlooking, and we overlooked, we ranked them low in the power rankings because we didn't know what these players were going to be. And now we're in this really funny situation where D plays tomorrow versus the Unicorns of Love, and then the 27th when they play V3 to end their group stage, Unified, their general starting AD carry, who's a very good player, one of the best players on the team, along with Kai Wing, that is the strength of PSG Talon, is going to come back. And then if they qualify, if they go 4-0, if they beat Unicorns of Love and they beat D3, they are automatically into the group stages where they will be bringing Tank and River back, their two South Korean imports, over Uniboy and Kongwei. And that's where it becomes interesting. That's where the story becomes very, very, I don't want to say awkward, but it's going to become very interesting if this team somehow 4-0s their group, and then half of the team gets switched out, two of the better performing members on the team.
So let's catch everybody up on what the options are here too. So obviously there were some visa issues for certain players, which led to the three substitutions, including D needing to play for PSG Talon. So now we are hearing that the three players have gotten their visa situation resolved, and now they're able to come to Shanghai, properly quarantine, and join the team. Now my question here is, what is the protocol? What if, hypothetical, on paper, certainly the original team would probably be the best scenario. However, do you also think about riding the hot hand? What if this team absolutely dominates and they are, the momentum is at an all-time high and now they're heading into groups? What are the options that PSG are faced with? Is it an automatic we have to go with the original team?
I think it's automatic. They have to go with the team that they qualified for. These were emergency subs. The only reason they were able to get Uniboy and Kongwei, and D for that matter, is because these were emergency visa subs and they came last minute. If all the other players have their visas cleared, it would be kind of, they would have to play at the starters that got them there, because there would be no more case of emergency, which makes it so ultra interesting, right? Where we could see PSG Talon destroy LGD, destroy V3 Esports, destroy Unicorns of Love, make it 4-0, then go to groups, and then we will never really know how strong this Taiwanese super team could have been, because we will have this different team, which is drastically different when you put River and Tank on the team than, you know, two Taiwanese-born players who can communicate well with the entire team and who have been excelling from what we've seen. It's a very, very strange situation where we might have a what-if story forever, where if they go 4-0 and then Tank and River come back and Unified come back, I think Unified and D, I don't think is that big of a change. I think it might actually strengthen the team. They're going to have a lot more bot lane agency with a Unified with Kaiwing in the bottom lane. But Tank and River coming back, it really sucks for those two players, right? Because it's not their fault. They went through the protocol. This is when their visa are getting cleared. They'll be cleared for the group stages, but it's always going to be a what if. How strong could this PSG Talon team be if they could play as a five stack in the group stages? So I'm excited to see how they play the next 2 days. I'm excited to see how, you know, D plays in a swung song tomorrow versus a very, very strong Unicorns of Love team. But it's going to be very, very strange in a few, you know, a few days when we're talking about River and Tank possibly coming back for the group stages. And it's not the PSG team that we've seen dominate and dice up LGD Gaming.
Just imagine PSG make groups, they fizzle out with the new team, though.
Yeah.
Like, that would be such a heartbreaking situation if you're a PSG Talon fan. Neymar's heart would be broken.
Oh, Neymar and Mbappe would be drastically sad from this moment. But I'm going to enjoy as it is, because right now, even if PSG Talon does flame out in the group stages or have BU, like, this is a story that we're going to remember for a long time. And no matter if tomorrow's D's last game or if, you know, he gets another game because the Unified's thing doesn't clear, I'm excited to see the coach, the old man, 26 years old, one of the oldest men in the competition.
Let's go.
Bring it one more time as a coach coming off the bench. I'm just excited to see how the story unfolds.